Now we take a next sum. In this sum, we will use all three methods of finding mean. Yes, there are three methods of finding mean. Direct method, shortcut method, and step deviation method. We will do this one sum with all the three methods. So in an exam, whichever method is asked, so you can do it very much easily. So take keen interest on this sum. It's a very, very important sum. See the sum which is given to you. I read the question for you. See what is given. Weight of 50 eggs. How many eggs are given to you? 50, 50. Okay. Were recorded as given below. See the weight and number of eggs are given to you. So what is given? Weight in grams and number of what? Eggs. 80 to 84 grams, there are how many eggs? 5 eggs. 85 to 89, there are 10 eggs. Further, 90 to 94 grams, there are 12 eggs. 95 to 99, there are 12 eggs once again. 100 to 104 grams, there are 8 eggs. And 105 to 109, there are 2 eggs over there. And last, in the last column, what is given to you? From 110 to 114 grams, there is 1 egg. See the, what the question says now. Calculate the mean weight to the nearest grams. I have to find the mean weight of all the eggs which are given to you. So, in short, I have to find the mean. I will do this sum by using direct method of finding mean. Direct method is equal to summation fx upon summation f. See what I am doing for you. Class interval. Okay. That is 80 to 84, 85 to 89, 90 to 94, and so on. Then you got frequency, that is the number of eggs become what? Frequency. And the weight has become what? The class interval. So frequencies are given to you. What are f over here? 5, 10, 12, 12, and so on. But we don't have x over here. Without x, I cannot find f into x. So my job is to find x. Now what is x over here? That's a mid value. Mid value of the class interval. See what's the first class interval, 80 to 84. So what I'll do, 80 plus 84, that is what, 164, divided by 2, I'll get what, 82. So that mid value of the first class interval, 82, is nothing but x. Like that, I'll go for a finding of the second x. That is 85 plus 89 divided by 2, I'll get what, 87. Similarly, I found all the mid values, there is nothing but x. What I got? 82, 87, 92, 97, 102, 107, 112. Now the last job is what? Is to find f into x, because I want to fill up that column, fx. Because I want to find summation fx. So how will I find f into x? Multiplication. F into what? X. So what is f over here? 5. What is x? 82. So 5 into 82 will give me what? 410. That is what? Fx. Similarly for a second one, for a second class interval, what's the mid value? 87. What's the frequency? 10. So after multiplication, what I get? 87 into 10 is what? 870. Very good. Like this, all multiplication of f into x will give me what the values? 410, 870, 1104, 1164. Then I get 816, then 214, and I get 112. These are all the values of what? Fx. If I club them together, if I add them together, I get summation fx. That is nothing but 4690. So 4690 is summation fx. And what is summation f? 50. So I got summation fx. I got summation f. How can I find mean now? Mean is equal to summation fx upon summation f. That is 4690 upon what? 50. After division, what I get? I get 93.8 grams. So 93.8 grams is nothing but what? Mean weight in this first method. By solving this sum with the first method, that is what, direct method of finding mean, I got the answer 93.8 grams. That is a mean weight of eggs in this sum. Now solving the same sum, but by using a different method, that is shortcut method. Shortcut method of finding what? Mean. So first of all, you should know the formula for that. See the formula which is given to you. Finding mean by using shortcut method. That is, mean is equal to A plus summation FD upon summation F. Now there is one new term for you, A. And there is one more new term, that is what, D. First of all, you should know the meaning of these two. What is A and what is D? What is A? A is nothing but assumed mean. I read once again for you. A is assumed mean. Okay? That means you assume the mean in advance. It's an assumed mean. And what is D? D is nothing but what? X minus A. And I hope you know what is X. X is the mid value of all the class intervals. Okay. Now, how to find A? A is what? Assumed mean. That is mid value of the middle class interval. What's that? Mid value of the middle class interval. Or in case there are two middle class intervals, we'll take the one with the higher frequency. We'll take the class interval with the higher frequency. And if both the class interval got the same frequency, then you can choose any one of them. I hope it's clear to you. For example, in our example, see, 80 to 84, 85 to 89, 90 to 94. So we have got in all 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 class intervals. So which is the middle class interval? The middle class interval is what? 95 to 99. Correct? Okay. What's the mid value of this? Come on. Yes. 97. Perfect. So 97 in this sum will become what you assume mean. So in this sum, 97 is nothing but A. That is what assumed mean. Understood? And in case there were two middle class intervals, then you can take any one of them. If the frequencies are same and if the frequencies are different, we'll take the one with the higher frequency. For time being, A is what? 97. Now, how to find D? See the D column, what I filled, how I've done. D is what? X minus A. That is what? X minus 97. See, in the first case, what is X? 82. 82 minus 97 will give me what? Minus 15. So, what is D over here? Minus 15. For the class interval, 82, 84. For the second class interval, what is X? 87. What is my A? 97. So after subtraction, what I get? Minus 10. So minus 10 is what D for the second class interval. Similarly, when you do it further, what do you get? Minus 5, 0, 5, 10 and 15. So minus 15 into 5 is what? Minus 75. Then minus 10 into 10 is what? Minus 100. Similarly, I get minus 60, 0, 40, 20 and 15. After adding them together, what I get? Summation FD. That's nothing but what? Minus 160. So minus 160 is summation what? FD. And summation F is what? 50. Already we know it. Now I solve the sum, or I'm finding mean by using what? Shortcut method. That is, mean is equal to A plus summation FD upon summation F. That is, mean is equal to 97 plus minus 160 upon 50. For the simplification, I get what? 97 minus 3.2. That is nothing but 93.8. So I got the same answer. Mean is equal to 93.8 grams. So answer is same, but the method is what? Different. Now the same sum we take it with the third method. Yes, step deviation method of finding mean. First, I will take the formula for this. Which formula or what formula I'm going to use it? Mean is equal to A plus summation FU upon summation F into I. Now, you know what is A. That is what assumed mean. But there are two new terms again in this formula. One is what U and second is what I. What is U? U is nothing but X minus A upon I. Yes. You know what is X? You know what is A? Divide by I. But what is I now? I is the width of the class interval. What is I? The width of the class interval. Or we say the size of the class interval. In this sum, what is the width of the class interval? Let's check it out. Let's see what is the width of the class interval. The class interval says 80 to 84. And next is what? 85 to 89. In the first class interval, it is 80 to 84. That means both the class intervals are included. So it's an inclusive class interval. So 80, 81, 82, 83, 84. So what's the width of the class interval? 5. Very good. So what is I in this sum? I is what? 5. Yes, we got all the raw materials. See what we have to find now. We have to first fill up the column of what U. X minus A upon I. That is 82 minus 97 divided by what? 5. Which will give me minus 15 upon 5. That is what? Minus 3. Similarly, I get minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, and 3. These are all the values of what? U. I want to find one more column, that is F into U. That is 5 into minus 3, which will give me what? Minus 15. Then it is 10 into minus 2, that is what? Minus 20. Similarly, I get other values of F U, that is what? Minus 12, 0, 8, 4, and 3. After adding them together, I get summation F U, that is what? Minus 32. And we already know what is summation F, that is what? 50. Now we put these values into the formula. What is the formula for finding mean? By using step deviation method, mean is equal to A plus summation F U upon summation F into what? I. So putting the values, what I get? 97 plus minus 32 upon 50 into what? 5. For the simplification, what I get? 97 minus 3.2, that is 93.8 grams. In this sum also, the answer is what? 93.8 grams. So whether you use the direct method or shortcut method or step deviation method, but one thing is very clear to all of you now, that the answer is what? 93.8 grams. In short, you can use any method for solving or for finding mean, depending upon what is asked in the examination. So a nice practice of all these three methods will give you a nice grip over the finding mean, will give you a nice grip on the problems on mean. See what is given in the next sum, in the next problem. We read the question, see what is given to you. The following table gives the daily wages of 50 workers. 50 workers of a factory. Now whenever they say 50 workers or 60 workers or 100 workers, what does this number suggest? That means summation F is given to you. So what is summation F in this sum will be? 50. Fantastic. Okay, what is given to you? Wages in rupees and number of workers. See, the wages are given in the form of class interval. 25 to 30, 30 to 35, 35 to 40, 40 to 45, 45 to 50, 50 to 55, and 55 to what? 60. And the number of workers are 2, 3, 5, 7, 21, 10, and 2 respectively in each class intervals. Now what the problem says now? See the question part of it, what is given to you. Calculate the mean daily wage of a worker of the factory. In short, we have to find the mean wage of a worker. What else? Something more is given to you. If the daily wage of all the workers are increased by rupees 8. Now this is interesting. The daily wage of each worker is increased by rupees 8. What else? What will be the new mean daily wage of a worker? We have to find the new mean daily wage of a worker. Ordinary mean wage of a factory worker. And then we see the new mean wage later on. Now how do we go? If nothing given, let's start solving the sum by direct method. Now what is required over here? Wages which are given in the class interval form. Then you got number of workers, that is nothing but what? Frequency. Then you have to find the mid value. Why? Because I want to find the value of what? X. And then the last column will be what? F into what? X, that is what? Fx. Okay, we copy the class interval as it is. We take the frequencies, that number of workers which are given to you. And the third column, we will find out the mid value, that is what? X. How to find the mid value? Lower limit plus the upper limit of the class interval divided by 2. That is 25 plus 30 divided by what? 2. Which will give me 55 divided by what? 2. That is 27.5. Similarly, I can find all the mid values. They are 32.5, 37.5, 42.5, 47.5 and 52.5, and lastly you got 57.5. These are all the values of what? X. Now we'll multiply with F to get what? Fx. See what I get. 27.5 into what? 2, that is what? 55. Then 32.5 into 3, that is what? 97.5. Similarly, the third one what I get is what? 187.5. The next one I get what? 297.5. The next is what? 997.5. Further what I get? 525. And lastly what I get? 115. These are all the values of what? Fx. If I add them together, I get summation Fx. That is nothing but summation Fx is what? 2275. Now this is summation Fx. I got the value of summation F already, that is what? 50. How to find mean now? Mean is equal to summation Fx upon summation F. That is 2275 upon what? 50, which gives me 45.50, that is what? Rupees 45.50. Now this is the normal mean, this is the ordinary mean, or this is the ordinary mean wage. But the problem says if each worker is increased by rupees 8, find the new mean wage. That is, now total increase in the wages will be rupees 8 into what? How many workers? 50. Yes. So total increase is what? Rupees what? 400. Now how to find the new mean wage? Okay, that is 2275 plus 400 upon 50, which is give me 2675 upon 50. That is nothing but 53.50. So rupees 53.50 is nothing but a new daily mean wage of the worker. So that's the answer. That is 53.50. And the sum gets over. Now in the next sum, we'll do some drawing part of it. We'll draw something. See what the question is given to you. Draw a frequency polygon. What do you draw over here? Frequency polygon. For the following data on a graph paper, what else? Labeling the axis properly. Now how to go for a frequency polygon? See the information which is supplied to you first of all. You got income in rupees, that is 800 to what? 1000. So what's the first class interval? 800 to 1000. Then you got 1000 to what? 1200. 1200 to what? 1400. And so on. And the last is 1600 to what? 1800. This is all the income in rupees. What else? Number of persons in 1000 given to you. That is what? 4. That means what? 4000. Okay, then next is what? 8, 20, 12 and 6. Now all this is what? Information. With this information, you have to draw what? A frequency polygon. Now, first of all, how to go for it? Can you start drawing with me? Okay, you can try. First of all, we need a graph paper. Okay, I think you got a graph paper next to you. Okay, now we got the class intervals and the number of what? Persons in 1000. That's what a frequency given to you. Now, always take the class interval on the x-axis of equal width. That is 800 to 1000, 1000 to 1200 and 1200 to 1400. All this class interval go onto the x-axis. See what I have done. on the x axis I have taken 1 centimeter is equal to rupees 200. That's why you see the dots, the markings which are given on the x axis. 600, 800, 1000, 1200, and so on, and goes up to what? 2000. You must be wondering, it is not up to 2000, why I have taken 2000? Always take one extra. That means what the ending is, what? 1800 will go up to what? 2000. And the beginning was what? 800, but I have started with what? 600. Okay. Now on the x axis, you can see kink is also there. What is there? Kink is there. You know why the kink is there? Because the class interval is not given you evenly. See, the starting is what? 0. On the x axis, what? 0. And straight away it goes to what? 600. Then what? 800. So what's the gap of each class interval? 200. But the starting gap is what? 600. So 600, 200, 200. That means the gap is not even. It's an uneven gap. So whenever the gap of class interval, or whenever the width of the class interval is uneven, we require a kink over there. But if the width of the class interval is given to you even, or it's the same throughout, right from the first one, there is no need of what? Kink. But over here, in this sum, definitely there is a need of what? Kink, because the class interval is not same. Now on the y-axis, I have taken what? Number of persons in what? 1000. See what I have taken? 4, 8, 12, 16. That means what I have done on the y-axis, 1 centimeter equal to what? 4000 persons. And this is the way I have plotted a point on the x and y-axis. Now what I am doing? I am taking the midpoint of each class interval. Okay. Now see the midpoint of 600 to 800 is what? The dot which is marked over there. Can you see that? Beautiful. Now the midpoint of 800 to what? 1000, there is a dot, but this is opposite to what? The first frequency. What is the first frequency? 4. So in opposite to the first frequency 4, we have plotted a point which is the mid value of 800 and what? 1000. Similarly, I have plotted a point opposite to what? 8. But once again, that's a mid value of what? 1000 to what? 1200. And the next dot has gone in front of what? 20. The frequency on the y-axis is what? 20. Opposite to that, in front of that, there's a dot which is the mid value of what? 1200 what? 1400. Similarly, I've got a dot opposite to what? 12. Yes, the frequency. And the next is what? 6. And finally, there's a dot in between 1800 to what? 2000. That's a mid value. When I join all these dots by a freehand curve or with the help of a scale, I get a frequency polygon. So this was a frequency polygon which was required, which was to be drawn when we have done it. So from above, it is clear that we have first found the midpoints of each class interval, correct? And then you put a dot in front of their respective frequencies on the y-axis. Yes or no? Yes, by doing this, we get that frequency polygon. Or by joining all the points then, we get what? Frequency polygon. So how do you get a frequency polygon? See over here, once again, small revision. We first found the midpoints of each class interval, and then we put a dot, where you put a dot? In front of their respective frequencies, which are given on the y-axis. And when you join these midpoints, or when you join all these points, we get a frequency polygon. And that's what you can see in front of you.